September 25, 2015. This is a 15-year-old Westie in good condition, actually. You can see that it's quite old. That's where the eyes are. Can you see or not?
Can see, but cannot hear.
Cannot hear. I check the ears. See any pain or not? A bit painful, but not very painful. But the left one is worse.
Left one.
It doesn't allow me to touch it all. So there is pain, so there may be a middle ear infection. Does he tilt the head to the right and left?
Oh, sometimes.
To the head.
Sometimes when he's walking
on. The left side?
I forgot which side.
So you can see there might be a slight head tilt, but now it looks okay. So normally there's a middle ear infection. Now the teeth has been scaled in June. So it looks okay. Now we check the gums. He's eating very well, right?
Yes.
This is a tumor, but this is due to long time. The pupils. Other than that, his teeth is in good condition. I'll check the lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are not swollen. Check the throat. Check all the lymph nodes first. Now this one is swollen. The prescapular lymph node is swollen. Let me check the submandibular. Submandibular is not swollen. Surprising, the prescapular is swollen here. The right prescapular lymph node is swollen. Then I check the armpit, the axillary. Axillary lymph node is not swollen. Nothing. Check the inguinal. Then the popliteal. Popliteal is here. It's a bit swollen also, a bit only. So popliteal and prescapular swollen. Then I check the other side. Okay, check the other side. Submandibular again. Not very swollen, but a bit. Now the prescapula is in front of the scapula. It's quite swollen. But not... it shouldn't be there, but this is the most... about half the size of a fish ball. About 3 centimeters across. Then I check here, the armpit. The axillary. Not swollen. Nothing. Inguinal. I have been licking and scratching this lower part. I check the lymph nodes. Nothing. Now I check the popliteal. Popliteal lymph nodes. This side is not so swollen, but it's there about 1 centimeter. About 1 centimeter diameter. Okay, now I check the inner sac. Inner sac gland. Come. In a sec now. This dog has been biting the whole leg for how long really? Since June, is it? Biting and causing infection. Now the inner sac here, there's a bit of swelling here. So it needs to be expressed. Otherwise it's very itchy. So I just express it. Now it's best the owner does it every week, but it's difficult for them. They do it on the table. This one can cause much itchiness.
Okay.
This is bad. I think last time was done once, but these are the deep ones. So the poor fellow has been trying to relieve his itch. Sometimes they don't know, they just bite here, they bite here, but they don't know exactly where it's itchy. Sometimes they bite the tail, sometimes they bite here, and sometimes they press on the floor. See that scooting? Sometimes he chase a circle, chase his tail, go around and chase the tail. See that?
Okay. No.
Let mosquito bite his tail. He doesn't do that.
Last time, not
last time. Last time was worse. So this inner sac is best to do weekly. Just use your hand to do like that.
Yeah, I know. I did for the bigger dog.
Why you didn't do one? I see you can see something.
Yeah, because I thought
this is bad.
Okay.
I see.
Okay.
Before bathing.
Okay.
The hand is better than the tissue paper.
Okay.
So this will account for his biting here.
Okay.
That's one thing. So this is not what I suspect was a disease of Westie. Because Westie they have one disease where they bite here. The whole skin is inflamed. But this shows that it's been many years. Because it comes to this color. Last time I did once, right? June?
June
Should I do one?
I don't know.
I wrote down inner sac.
Okay.
But probably not all can come out like this.
Okay.
And when I say, okay, so now the treatment of choice is I have to irrigate the ears and shape pot to take out all the infected hairs.
Okay.
Then at least it can have ventilation and heal.
Okay.
Otherwise, even if you give wash, it doesn't get rid of all the infected hairs. Is it?
Okay.
All these are like the undergrowth of the jungle. You got to clear the jungle.
Okay.
So, and then there's a lot of flakes. So that the first thing to clear the infected hairs and then the recovery should be quite fast. Okay, turn upside down, let's see again. 1, 2, 3. Now we see here.
Okay, this one
has been quite long, this part.
Yeah, all black.
Since June, is it, or before that?
Yeah, before that is also like that.
Now the interesting part about this dog is that this prescapula is enlarged. Now, this is not lymphoma, the lymphoma, all the lymph nodes will be enlarged. But this prescapula is enlarged. This shows that there's some infection from the surrounding areas. And this part also properly is enlarged. But the others are not enlarged, like axillary. So this is not a lymphoma case. So I suspect this property is enlarged because the infection from the surrounding areas, the lymph nodes enlarge to fight the bacteria, to stop the bacteria from going further. So this one, and this is quite a rare case of specific enlargement of the lymph nodes. Because normally if it's a lymphoma, the whole lymph nodes here, the submandibular, prescapular, axillary, inguinal and popliteal they enlarge. So this is not lymphoma. So it's most likely a bacterial infection. The body is trying to control it by enlarging it to fight the surrounding drainage. So the other thing is that you do want a blood test done, check on his kidney and liver. So that we know his health, general health. And his kidney and liver was okay last time. Then of course then you know that you don't need special diet.
Okay,
nice.